Now it's time for our team from Scotland, Team Glasgow.
Did we start? Okay. Hi, I'm Theo and this is Ina, and we are from the University of Glasgow. Along with the other members of the team, we have developed a LoveWave biosensor for heart failure detection. But what are the basic components of our biosensor? Well, we have a microfluidic pump, a microfluidic cartridge, we also use magnetic beads, a LoveWave sensor, and we have the electronics and power input. But how does the heart of our biosensor works, the surface acoustic wave sensor. It is based on the effect of on the piezoelectric effect. We have a piezoelectric crystal, as we can see, and two interdigital transducers, which are metal electrodes. When we have an input signal, an input electrical signal, this creates an electric field on the metal fingers, which vibrate the substrate through the piezoelectric effect and create an acoustic wave that travels along the delay line on the substrate. If there is something added on the delay line, an added mass, an added weight, it changes the phase and the frequency of the acoustic wave while it travels. Then the altered acoustic wave reaches the second IDT, becomes an electric signal again. And finally, we compare the output signal with the input to quantify whatever was on the delay line. On our sensor, we have added antibodies on the delay line, anti-proBNP antibodies, which collect the anti-proBNP and measure the weight difference. However, there is an issue with the LoveWave sensors as well. They have a limit of detection on a few nanograms per ml. In order to overcome this, we try to innovate and introduce magnetic microparticles on the sample that collect as much as NT-proBNP as possible, and when they conjugate to the surface of the sensor, they amplify the weight of the NT-proBNP and make it detectable.
Yep. So this is our microfluidic cartridge. This is the spot where you insert the plasma magnetic bead mix. This travels along meander patterns which wait in the mix to reach the two sensors, the control and the positive one. Also, we have slots for electromagnets at the bottom to further aid in the mix. There is an oil reservoir which we use to finger press the plasma through. And then two wash compartments which are used for three washes at three different time intervals. Under the two devices, we have another magnet that speeds up the process of detection by drawing the magnetic particles to the bottom. The micro channels were cut into 2 millimeter thick perspex, and all the waste is collected at the bottom of the sensor. The case is 3D printed as well. The electronics and power input part. In the initial plan, we had a phase loop lock circuit which would have identified the frequency, and then a phase counter would have basically translated our phase frequency into something, a concentration of NT-proBNP. Then the electromagnets, as I said, would have aided in mixing the beads and the magnetic particles. The motor circuit and power supply would have pumped at initial time intervals the fluid through. These are results based on one cartridge. So as you can see, the frequency change between the addition of the plasma and the first wash shows a decreasing frequency, which means, yes, indeed, there were particles there that sense NT-proBNP. Kind of success needs a lot more testing, as this is not significant for a large concentration span. Thank you for your time. Do you have any questions?
Any questions? Yes?
How long does it take to get the test results?
Well, this is why we introduced the beads. Without the microparticles, you need to wait at least half an hour for the conjugation to happen. With them, Can I use this? We need the introduction of the microbeads and the magnet that is below the surface here. You can actually make the reaction happen quicker because you attract the whole thing down, and it goes below 10 minutes.
Any further questions? Okay, then I want to thank you for your pitch. Again, once again.
And thank you both. Thank you so much.